Hi, Gerard here. Welcome to Learn Delphi. In this video, we will explore more things we can do with mathematical operators, functions, procedures, and expressions with this project we started in the last video. Last time, we learned how to use Delphi's built-in square function to square a number. We also looked at the order of precedence of mathematical operations with an acronym called buttmass. We already coded this part of the user interface to calculate the perimeter and the surface of a square. And we also calculated this section to calculate the perimeter and the surface of a rectangle. Today, we will calculate the circumference and the area of a circle. You may need to go back to Unit 12.2 and watch that video to learn how to use floating point numbers and Delphi's built-in Pi function before you continue with this lesson. In every video, we focus on a specific lesson and use those concepts in a sample project. We do our project step by step and test our code at regular intervals to see the results after I explain the code. We also add comments to describe what the code is doing, so that you can revisit the code later and read the comments to make sense of it. I do not walk you through the development of the user interface so that you only focus on the code of the lesson we are doing, but you can download the user interface and any other assets I use in the project to start immediately where I start with the lesson. The starter project files of the project is available for download on my Patreon page at patreon.com/learndelphi if you want to do the rest of the project with us. I also posted the link to my Patreon page in the video's description, along with another link to also download the free legal copy of Delphi 10.3 Community Edition. So pause the video here, go do the downloads and get your setup ready. Then meet me here again to do the rest of the project with me. This is how the project looks in my copy of Delphi. If you have your project open, let's start. Today we will calculate the circumferences and surfaces of circles. The circumference of a curved shape, like a circle, is the length of the perimeter or the outside border of the shape in a measurement unit like millimeters, centimeters, inches, feet, or whatever measurement unit you prefer. The surface or area is the size of the inside of the shape, which can be measured in square meters, square inches, square kilometers, square feet, or any unit you prefer. Let's first see what we require from the user. We need to know the distance from the center to the outer border of the circle. That is called the radius. We also need to know what the value of pi is. The radius must be provided by the user in this spin edit. We will find the value of pi with one of Delphi's built-in functions. Double-click the Calculate button in the Circle section. Go under Begin and type bar. Enter and type int radius as integer. Press Enter. Type SNG circumference, comma SNG area as single. Int radius is an integer that must store the distance from the center of the circle to the outer border. SNG circumference must store the length of the border of the circle, and SNG area must store the size of the surface of a circle. We declare the variables for the circumference and the area as type single, because we must use the value of pi to calculate those values, and pi is a floating point number. Let's outline our steps again with comments. Go under Begin and type three comments to separate input, processing, and output. Go under Input and type another comment, get radius. Go under Processing and type this comment, calculate circumference, 2 pi times radius. 2 pi times radius is the formula to calculate the circumference of a circle. To make the Greek pi symbol, you can use Alt plus 227. Press Enter, add this comment, calculate surface, pi, r square. The formula to calculate the surface of a circle is pi radius square. To make the power of 2 superscript, use Alt and 253. Go under Output and type this comment. Display circumference. Press Enter and type another comment. Display surface. Make a new line under this comment. Type int radius colon equals SED radius dot value. Here we read the value the user provides in the spin edit and assign it to the integer variable named int radius. Make a new line under this comment. Type SNG circumference colon equals 2 times pi times int radius. I already explained Delphi's pi function when we explored floating point numbers in unit 12.2, but let's recap. Pi is a floating point number that is never ending, and the sequence of its number never repeats. Delphi represents pi as an extended floating point number with 19 significant digits. You can go back to unit 12.2 and watch that video if you are not familiar with pi, floating point data types, precision of decimal numbers, and significant digits. We will use pi twice in this project, once to calculate the circumference and once to calculate the area of circles. The formula to calculate the circumference of a circle is 2 pi radius. So here we multiply 2 to the value of pi and multiply it again with the radius that the user provided in the spin edit that we stored in the integer variable called int radius. The result is then assigned to the single variable named SNG circumference. Make a new line under this comment. Type SNG area colon equals pi times int radius times int radius. The formula to calculate the surface of a circle is pi radius squared. So we call the pi function and multiply it with the radius and multiply it with the radius again. Then we assign the result to SNG area. In the last video, we explored Delphi's built-in square function, so we can also use that. But let's first do it this way. Now let's do the output. Make a new line under this comment. Type this statement. We take the value in SNG circumference and convert it to a string, while also formatting the number to a fixed float format of 4 digits with 4 decimal places. Then we assign it to the caption of a panel named PNL circle circumference. We use the float to string f function to do the conversion and formatting, which I also explained in unit 12.2. Make a new line under this comment. Type this statement. Here we read the value in SNG area and convert it to a string, while also formatting it to a fixed float format of 4 digits with 2 decimal places, with the float to string f function. Then we assign it to the caption of a panel named PNL circle surface. Now run the project. Enter 10 for the radius. Click the calculate button. The circumference must be 62.83 and the area is 314.20. Make a note of those values because we will compare it after making a change in our code. Close the form. Go back to the code where you calculate the area. Type 2 slashes in front of this statement to hide it from the compiler. Make a new line and type this statement. We take pi and multiply it with the square of the radius. In other words, radius times radius. So this must produce the same result as the statement we commented out. Let's see. Run the application. Remember, the previous result of a radius of 10 was 62.83 for the circumference and 314.20 for the area. Let's see if we get that same result. Make the radius 10 and click calculate. We get 62.83 and 314.20. So the results are the same when we use the square function. But how will we know that our statements produce the correct results? Let's compare it with an independent source. Here I googled for a calculator to calculate the circumferences of circles. If I type 10, it produces the same result as my application. Here I also have a calculator to calculate the surface of a circle. A radius of 10 produces more or less the same result as my calculation. There is a small difference because the float to string f function we used is also rounding up or down. In our case, it rounded the decimal digits up from 0.16 to 0.20. You also learned that in unit 12.2. So the Google calculator just calculates it with greater precision. But you can do the same if you change the parameters for your float to string f function. You can now go and try more inputs and test it with an independent source to make sure that your calculations work fine. I've seen some nice questions in exam papers and school assignments where students are asked to do all kinds of calculations with rectangles, squares, and circles. For example, a carpet business that cuts out circular carpets from a rectangular piece, and they want to calculate the trimming or cut-off pieces to sell to a recycling business. Now that you know how to calculate measurements of rectangles, squares, and circles, it should be easy to also do those kinds of calculations. Go and try it. While you are playing around with the measurements of shapes, you can also try to calculate triangles and maybe add it to this space on your form. The formula to calculate the perimeter of a triangle is the length of side A plus side B plus side C. And to calculate the area of a triangle, you must use the formula of the base times the height. So you must get the length of the base and the height of the triangle to do your calculations. But also consider that the user's input must add up to draw a perfect triangle. For example, if the base is very long and the other two sides are short, the triangle may not close properly. Or if the height is out of proportion, it may not add up to draw a proper triangle. You may also want to ask the user for the size of one angle of the triangle to do a proper calculation. With enough valid information from the user, you can then also calculate the other angles and display that somewhere on your form. I will leave that up to you. Share your ideas and code in the comment section of this video. Next time, we will continue with mathematical procedures, functions, operators, and expressions in a new project. If you had fun with this project, leave a comment under the video. And if you learned something new, please like, subscribe, and share my lessons with your friends. Thank you for watching, and a special thank you to my supporters on Patreon.com. Happy coding! See you next time!